rich feel, which is good for you. And it made it a base in my cylinder. My nan was actually quite a really nice, like, watercolor artist, and I always listened to her. And my mum was also has a very big imagination, so that kind of encouraged me to also have a very big imagination. And when I was at school, I kind of daydreamed a lot. I did want to follow the meat, like lines, so I just kind of went all over the lines. My teacher shouted at me and then at me, oh, I like this. She's reacting, I want to make her more angry. It's just always something that I'm always happy to.
I was in my student halls and I had a printout and I accidentally spilled a cup of coffee on it and then I re-scanned it and yeah, and then I kind of saw that it looked quite interesting, and then I then started to do that with all my prints, trying to still keep that physical element, like using film photography, but then using my little techniques. After I've manipulated them a lot, the outcome, they look rather like paintings, as a lot of people say, and a lot of people, I don't realise that they are actually photographs until they actually go up to it and they look closely, and they're like, ooh! I'm really interested in this young artist, and it was actually me, and he wanted to buy my work. And then I found out that he was a famous Iranian rapper, but he